you show some ways how to practice program for the robot. I will use MasterCam, this robot master. So the first step we start, it's load the 3D model. Then we have to locate origin of coordinate system. For this, I will choose tool transform, highlight the part, locate origin of coordinate system. I need to rotate it. This has been done in this way. Z axis in up direction related to the surface of the model. Then I will create a reference line for the trajectory of full motion. From the top, I will create a reference line of distance 400 millimeters, and then and then one for the full motion. So it was first preparation. In the next step, I need to define our machine. In this case, it would be robot cooker. When I create the machine for the treatment, then we have the possibility to create the operation. First of all, it will be contour trajectory. I will choose this line, reverse direction. So it is appearing the tool for definition of this first operation. First of all, we need to define tools for the process. I will select it from the library tool. And, I have to modify the folder. Then I need to prepare cut parameters. I switch the compensation type to four. So within our parameters will be 10 millimeters distance. To approach the tool for the vertical operation. And in this stage it will be okay, then let's see. how we can watch this. The first motion was for operation for the treatment along the first trajectory. So now the next step, we need to process the top surface of this polygon. So this, I will choose space operation, designate this top surface. As you see, it's highlighted. Then I repeat the same step as for previous operation. Definition of the tool folder and then cut parameters. Here we choose zigzag tool motion style. Then I need to modify movement of the tool between the contiguous motion along the surface. Depth cut, I switch to. In this window, you can see the reference heights for the full motion along the operation. So I finish here and let's see. This create a trajectory. We can modify, with the possibility to modify this angle of roughness. Go. So I need to, for example, we will rotate this motion to trajectory for 45 degrees. Recalculate it and we can observe two types of created operations. The first one was contour process, and the second one surface process. So in this step, creation of program in MasterCam is finished. And next step, we need to configure our robot. For this reason, we go to the Robot Master tab, switch this. So here we can see the message that we need to configure the global settings for the robot and the tool. So first of all, we need to prepare global settings. Here we need to choose appropriate robot and tool for this operation. And the next step, we have to allocate our parts in respect to the robot base position. Firstly, I designate reference values, then I modify them. So the first three axes, that means orientation of the part, and ABC axis, No, it was mistake. X, Y, Z, it was a location of the origin of base of the mass system, and ABC, it was orientation of the star according to the robot. Then two data previously defined values, it's two contact points offset from the end of the robot arm. In this window, this complete operation. Next one is the approach and retract. That means robot joins values before the operation and after the program is complete. That is, I will stay by default. Then tool configuration. Here I switch this one and configuration of this to negative one. Then motion configuration. So there is for the robot, as it is known, three basic motion types. It's, point to point, linear motion, and circular motion. And also it's possible to define type of this motion. The zigzag position on a programmable point or without or with some approximation. Okay, it's given types of three types of approximation of the trajectory. So in this window we complete this setup. So as you can see, this robot is appearing, but we need to pick up him. So first of all, we need modified local settings for the first operation. In the first string, we can say orientation of the tool related to the part which we need to process. In our case it will be top orientation, so possible front, side, and so on. The most important thing is to calculate tool orientation along the trajectory of motion. Then I press calculation. The green light denotes that everything is okay, so I can press OK. So it's just on. So now we can see that first trajectory is highlighted. Next step we need to locate the part on the table of positioner. I press the part and then it's possible to position our part on the table. Change the view to the right and one more preparation. Also it's possible for exit positioning to use the numerical values which we can take from our robot after calibration the base coordinate, also known as frame. So here we can see list of points which corresponds to this trajectory by highlighted it the tool in order to execute this position. This window is a representation of robot joint angles values, which also is possible to configure and modify. So cross operation is complete. We can by movement of slider we can simulate the process, and also we can repeat it by press play button. So the next operation we have to recalculate again to orientation by place the purple waves. Now we can examine this. Set the same. So the first of all we can see that long trajectory means that this is no load trajectory, and on the surface it's process trajectory. Also we can switch on frame for every point. We can show the vectors of full orientation during the motion. So also it's possible to highlight the robot work range. And also it's possible to show the robot itself. So the same cell is equipped our laboratory and our consumers. But I don't need this word. It's also switched off. So here I can see that this is a little bit dangerous situation. To avoid full collision during the motion, I will modify the retract position of cross operation. It will be done in the following way. Switch this cross operation, and I have to modify retract value on Z axis, for example, 150. Okay, and you can see that the no load motion is a little bit displaced along the position. Now it's possible to simulate the load process. Important is to generate force and force for I need to work it on real robot. This will be done by press this generate program button, then press it here, and I can write some name. You can see this code expert program with you, and here we can observe this created code. So first operation performed the one linear motion. Here we can see procedure for two to on. This is the switch of the this now appears it is a laser beam. Then after both editor here, this tool will be switched to off. And then again to off, long port for the surface operation, and on the end to off and motion to the home position. So for example, by technological reason we have to rotate tool for the first operation. This could be done in local settings. For this I need to line on the 90 degrees, and we need to recalculate this position. And let's see. So now we can see that the tool is rotated related to this first movement. And then again to the second operation. Next time we need to again to regenerate program. And now we can see that I access very well now. This moment is minus 90 degrees. So that was the first exercise. Next one I will show the complicated surface treatment. I load the next one part. So here we need to process the stop surface, and again I need to first of all I need to relocate this origin of coordinate system. First of all, I highlight the part. Have to take the dynamic tool. Next step we need to reorient this origin. see that everything on the base internet now is replaced. Then again, in the first step, we need to tape our machine, in this case, the robot cooker. And I will choose multi-axis operation, and I will choose method flow. And again, the same procedure. First of all, I need to take the appropriate tool. So the important thing is to define surface to be precise. Change this button and highlight top surface. I need to reorient these flow lines by placing zigzag cutting method, compensation type will switch off, and then distance belong distance between contiguous motion of tool will be 20 millimeters. And then to access control related to the surface. So it's possible to modify the output format which corresponds to the possibility of our machine. As we have a 6-axis robot, we can briefly use 5-axis method. So, next we will stay a bit by default. Let's see. Clearance motion goes exactly inside the part. It means something goes wrong. also distributed. Here we can see the motion of the tool along the treatable surface. So on this stage, programming by MasterCam is finished, then we need to switch robot master. Steps of preparation. First of all, global settings, drain of the robot, tool, then again frame data, origin of the base coordinate. Activation and risk configuration to negative. Then press OK. Then we have to modify the local settings of the operation and important is to calculation of motion. So here we can see that this tool line now is red. That means that we have singularity on the way of the tool motion. But first of all, we need to locate our part. Position it on the table. Then one more view, right here. Also we need to rotate it. Now we can get us the way to the trajectory. But if this red sign, it means that in some way that is unreachable position for the robot. By pressing this button, we can observe where is the mistake. So to solve this problem, go again to the operation setup. Perform the calculation of the trajectory. Try to avoid this problem. Now we can see this line is green, that means no problem. On the motion way, press OK. Now we can observe can also see that every line consists of discrete lines. That means that along this curve this greatness step, we can configure it only on MasterCam. But to finish our task, we have to generate this program for real robot. Here we can see how long is the code on this way. So to create it in teaching mode basically on the robot would be really, really very difficult. So if we have some more time, so I can show some programs also in the minutes. Yes. I have also time or no? Okay, that's one more exercise I will present to you. So again I need to load new one model. Then again, first step, relocation of the part. For this reason I use transform tool, then dynamic, highlight it, and then set up of the origin. For this part we need to process this for surface of origin. First of all I choose machine type and I will define this operation by parallel method. Identification of weather folder. So here we need to define options for this operation. First of all I have to take this edge. Set up for entry and for the crush of the glue method direct. Let's see the telephone. This way. Let's simulate it. So then to create the operation for next three surfaces, we can repeat again this this operation, this pattern, but also it's possible only rotate it. It means to create the array of this trajectory. So this I take transform operations, click rotate, and put this copy source operation and some adjustment of this option. Here I need to define center point of rotation. This vertex. Let's see. You have just copied the previous operation three times. First step in MasterCam, then we switch to the Robot Master. And again the same adjustments. Definition of the robot, definition of the tool. Definition of origin of the part. Then go for second for this second operation. Just to avoid the motion. And rotation of our object. Not in the center, but it works well. Now we can draw simulation of this process. frequency, and also we have one more type to perform this process. Here I plan to I can also use the combined rotary sensors, and this way the motion is happening this way, like you can see. So to move a little bit parallel to the floor. And then on the finish we have to bring the program. So this is the list of four phases. Even with four surfaces, for the two will be switched on four times. And the same for the activation. So for this one part could be created as a possible and repeated four times. So the last one, that I would like to present to you, it will be helping me to process this spherical surface. First of all, obtain this machine robot programs, and then two pass multi-surface, and maybe an adjustment for the tool. Modification of program. Here I need to designate the surface to be received. So this one's here. The card direction has been modified and start from the top. So, cutting method by spiral, compensation of two for both, and between contiguous motions, distance will be horizontal 15 millimeters, 15. And here we have to define two axis control. It will be a good point. This one. Again, a 5-axis output format. Now we can see. So on preview, we can see that two go visibly on the current values. And it's a mistake. To solve this problem, I designate the check surface, and I will deduct it from 1 millimeter to up on the surface. So that was first step, then again go to the robot master. So here is again sign of it, which shows us that here is a problem of arrangement. It's on this point. And to resolve it, we can modify the orientation of the longer trajectory. And this line is red, and on this way, red and brown colors designate that there is singularity of robot joints and also over travel. But to resolve it, I just change this angle of full orientation along the trajectory of motion. Now it's green. And in this way there is no mistake on this iteration. One more. small way to resolve this problem. I reset the saturation and switch the whole position. I rotate it on 25 degrees. It works in. So it will be done also in the same in this way. So by using MasterCam software and the RobotMaster, we have flexibility to create a necessary program for our robot. So thank you for attention. It was a short introduction to our advanced robot programming.